What do you think this stand weighs?
1 ton? 100 tons? Probably more than that. All held together on top of these pillars? Actually, I feel a little uneasy standing here. The key to its strength, of course, lies in the structural design. Steel and concrete are strong materials, sure, but the way we connect and support them is what keeps this building upright. Well, just like building stadiums, the way we stack and connect atoms also determines the properties of the final structure. Chemistry is about building things at the atomic level. We just have to know the rules to follow. This unit is going to show us the rules, and then we can build.
This is real chem.
As a kid, I used to love making ramps for my bike to do jumps and tricks. This taught me some really basic rules about how to make things strong. The supports, the structure, even the struts and reinforcements for my bike. I still love building things. But these days, I build instrumentation that allows me to look at structures and properties of molecules and molecular aggregates. It is by understanding atomic structures that we can understand the world around us. The building blocks of the world around us are simply atoms and bonds. Let's take diamond and graphite as simple examples. Both of them are made solely of carbon atoms, but just bonded together in very different ways. One making very beautiful and hard crystal, diamond. The other making a very cheap filler for your pencils, graphite. Maybe they connect with an ionic bond, or with a covalent bond. Maybe with a new type of bond you haven't looked at yet, like polar covalent bonds. The point being that how I connect them follows important rules, but the resulting connection will determine almost everything about the material we produce from these atoms, their strength, their conductivity, their solubility, their reactivity, even their smell. If I build with carbon, I have to bear in mind it has 4 valence electrons. This makes it especially versatile in how we arrange electrons to make bonds with other things. This allows us to connect carbon atoms in many different ways, resulting in such different structures. In diamond, our carbon atoms define a 4-pointed tetrahedral shape. Strong covalent bonds between carbon atoms create a 3-dimensional network lattice of these tetrahedrons, resulting in the remarkable hardness and exceptional optical properties of diamond. In graphite, our carbons all lie in a planar sheet connected by weak forces that slide apart easily. We can even now make layers of graphene, 1 atom thick, a material that is revolutionizing microconductor technology. Both substances have incredible properties, both defined by the structures we use to build. How we connect atoms matters. But carbon is just one example of so many. The point is that if we learn how to build, then we can make truly incredible things.
This unit starts with ionic and covalent bonding, the standard way of connecting the blocks, you might say. We look at Lewis structures, really just like architectural drawings of the buildings. We then start to look at polarity and hybridization, when the way we connect the building blocks requires special attention due to the particular properties of the materials we're using.
This unit gives us the skills we need to build at the atomic level. So let's get to work. This is Real Chem.